Hey everyone, it's Jacob with another daily vlog. Man, it's been a pretty rough few weeks. I'm here in the Bay Area, so we've been on a shelter-in-place order for the past few days. And so I'm just out right now taking the dogs for a walk. And, you know, it's not easy because we were also just told that schools might stay closed for the rest of the calendar year and not open until the fall. Which for Blake and I, well, and for most, for everybody, what am I even saying? You know, it's tough because you need that childcare so that you can work, so that you can do the things that you need to do. So we're trying to figure out what we're going to do if that actually happens. Thankfully, today we've been home with our three-year-old, and we've been using this time while we're at home to record a new course for Blake. I'll probably try to record some new courses as well. But one of the things that I really noticed, and what I wanted to talk about today, is even when I go to the stores like Safeway or Target, people are still very civil, they're very kind to each other, which I think is really important. And so even though it appears like there's a lot of chaos everywhere, and you know, the scenario doesn't look good and the stock market isn't going well, which is, man, that's been its own tough thing. I think what's really important is that we can control how we respond, and we can control our attitude, and we can control, you know, just basically our feelings, and we can control our own headspace. And it's interesting because there are different, you know, you can look around you and see different friends and family members you have, and you can see how different people react. And there are some people who are totally freaking out and are depressed and angry and frustrated. And there are other people who are more in control of their headspace, and they still have a positive attitude. They still treat other people with respect. They still walk into the stores and they say please, they say thank you, and they're being kind. So that's really kind of what I'm learning from all of this, is that you can still control your mindset, you can still control your attitude and being a good human being and be polite to others. And I know it's tough. Even when I was at Safeway, you know, somebody yelled at me when I was at the grocery store because apparently I was touching too many items. And you know, I didn't respond favorably, and I regret how I responded, but you know, what are you gonna do? So I hope that we can all, myself included, learn that even in this tough time, let's still treat other people with respect, let's still say please, let's still say thank you, and let's remember that this too will pass, just like all bad things typically do, and we'll come out on the other end stronger than we are now. And see, try to look for the silver lining, see where there are opportunities. Like I said, Blake and I are using this time at home to spend more time with our three-year-old, to read, to focus on courses, to plan for the future, to think about our businesses and what we want to do and how we want to do it. We're not just sitting around thinking, you know, how depressed and miserable we are and how bad everything is. That kind of headspace is not going to get you very far. So try to look for the positives, look for opportunities when you can see them, and still remember to treat other people with decency and be a human being, because we're all in this together at the end of the day. So I hope you're having a wonderful day. I know I usually say that, it's probably not easy, but I still hope you're having a wonderful day wherever in the world you are. And remember, we will ultimately get through this in the long run, and everything will be okay. See you soon.